Hello friends, today we'll show you how to program a Yokins Make YI564. It's a three-phase multifunction meter with LCD display. So today we'll tell you how to program CT and PT ratios in the same. So to program, enter into programming mode, we can see four buttons are there. So we'll press these two buttons, the down button and right button together for few seconds to enter in programming mode. Once we press it for few seconds, we can see the first zero starts blinking and it's saying enter password. So our standard password is 1000. So we'll enter 1000 to enter into programming mode. So the first digit zero, we can see it's blinking. We will press up button once, it will change to one. Now we'll press right button. The second digit will start blinking. As the password is 1000, we need not change it. We'll press right button again. The third digit will start blinking. I will press right button again. You can see four digit is blinking. We need not change this. We'll press right button again. So we can see it's showing enter password right. So now the password which we have entered is right. If our password would have been wrong, then it will show the wrong over here and we won't be able to change the settings. Now we'll press down button once. We have entered into setting mode. It's showing PT primary 415. So this is by default, which is set. So if we are not using any PT, we need not change it. But if we are using any PT, we will have to enter the primary PT ratio over here. Like if we are using a PT of 11 kV/110 volt, we'll enter 11 kV over here. So to enter 11 kV over here, we'll press right button once, the 4 will start blinking. We'll press down button and change it to 1. So we can see the first digit has changed to 1. We'll press right button, the second one will start blinking. We need not change it, then again press right button, third digit will start blinking. We need to change it to 0, as 11 kV we need to enter. So we'll press down button and make it 0. We'll press right button again, the 4 digit will start blinking. Again press down button, the decimal will start blinking. Now we need to shift the decimal. We need to make it 11 kV. We'll press down button once. We can see it has changed to 1.1 kV. Yes, it's K has started coming over here. So that this means 1.1 kilovolt. We'll press again down button. We can see now it changed to 11 kV. We want to save it. We will press right button once. So now it's saved. Whenever we are editing anything, we can see the edit will come here, and when we have edited it, the menu will start coming. Now we'll press down button once. We can see PT secondary over here. We need to change it to 110 volt. Now we'll press right button once. See, the menu will change to edit when we'll press right. Now it has changed to edit and the first digit has started blinking. Now we need to change it to 1. We'll press down button and change it to 1. And press right button. We need not change it. Then again 5 is blinking. We'll change it to 0. Now it's 110. Press right button. Again right button. Now we need not change the decimal place as it's already correct. It's already showing 110 volt. K is not there. We need to keep in mind that K should not be over here whenever we don't require it. It should only be there when we are programming it in a kilo range, like 11 kV or any ampere current, high current if you want kilo. Like if we are using 5000 ampere, and that time we can set it as 5 kilo ampere. We'll press right button again. The edit will go, menu has come. So we have saved it to 110. Now we'll press down button again. Now CT primary is there. Like if we want to set a CT ratio of 600/5 ampere, so we need to change it to 600 in that case, the CT primary. We'll press right button one, 5 will start blinking. We'll press up button, it will change to 6. We'll press right button. Need not change it. Then again press right button, again change right button. Once again, we'll press right button. The decimal will start winking. Now we need to shift the decimal two places. We'll press down button twice and it will change to 600. So we can see now the CT primary has been set as 600. We'll press right button again and now the 600 has been selected. Now we'll press down button. We can see CT secondary over here. We need not change CT secondary as CT ratio is 600/5 ampere. If our CT ratio is like 100/1 ampere, in that case our secondary current will be 1 over here. So we'll have to change 5 to 1 over there. But here, as we are using a CT of 600/5 ampere, we need not change it. Then press down button. It shows baud rate. This is for RS-485. We can select from different baud rates. Then this is parity. This is again for RS-485. We can select the parity required. Device ID. This is again for RS-485. Enter clear. Events clear. So there are different events which are recorded in this meter. So if we want to clear all those events, we'll have to change it to yes. We'll press right button once and no will start blinking. We'll press down button and it will change to yes. Then again press right button. Okay, now we'll press down button. Now energy clear. Similarly, there are different readings of KWH, KVRH. We can reset all of them from here. So if we want to reset all of them, we'll press right button once, no will start blinking. We'll press down button, it will change to yes, and then again press right button. Now we'll press down button. Run R clear. So all the readings of run R will be cleared from here. We'll press right button once, no will start blinking. We'll press down button, yes will come. We'll press again right button. Now we'll press down button. Time setting will be there. We can change the time if we feel the time and date are wrong. We can change it from here. So we'll press right button and then can change anything. So now we are not changing it. We'll press down button. Now it shows save and exit. If we want to save all the settings which we have done, we'll press right button. Make sure whatever settings you are doing, you will have to save it. If you don't save it, that those settings will not be saved in this. So by pressing right button once, all those settings which we have made will be saved in this meter. So now we have selected PT ratio of 11 kV/110 volt in this and CT ratio of 600/5 volt in this. I hope you have understood the same. Thank you.